Hi viewers, today here we are going to see about Python dictionaries. So what is meant by a dictionary? A dictionary consists of a word and its meaning. Same way we have a dictionary type in a data type in Python which will have a key value pair. So here you can see like it will be a key colon value. It's a pair of key and value. So for creating an empty dictionary you can use d equals to curly braces. So when you use a curly braces, a dictionary will be created. In order to check whether an object is dictionary type or not, you use print of type of d. So in order to check, it will give you class dict. In order to check the methods that are available along with the dictionary object, you can use dir of d. It will give you clear, copy, form keys, get, keys, values, pop key, update, items and pop item. So what are actually these mean and how we are going to use them? Let us see in a clear way. So in brief, so clear, as we by now by understanding the clear function, you may have understanding that if any values are there in a data type, it will be clearing all the values. It will return an empty dictionary. So here I consist of a value d equals to a key, and apple is a value. So 2:2 is a 2 is a key, 2 is a value, float is a key, 10.2 is a value. So we have key value pairs now. When I use clear, it will return me an empty dictionary. Copy. A copy will do the shallow copy. A copy will do a shallow copy. That means when I use d dot copy, so d dot copy, when I use, it will copy entire dictionary elements to the new dictionary object d2. It will create a new dictionary object d2 and it will copy all the elements of dictionary to d2. So this is called a shallow copy. That means direct copy of the elements to new object. Then we have form keys. So you have a sequence but you don't have a dictionary. You want to convert a sequence to a dictionary, then we will have form key. So what it will do, it will take the sequence and it will convert a sequence into a dictionary. Let us take a set. A set consists of 1, 2, 3 and you are passing it to form keys. Form key of s, 10. Defaultly, if you won't give the value, it will be none. So here you can use converting a set now is converted to a dictionary. Set is now converted to a dictionary. You need to typecast it with dict. Got it? Then get off. So in order to get the values from the using a key, we can use in a dictionary order. If you want to view, we can use a get function. Usually these values apple 2 and 10.2 are the values you can access using their indexes. Here the index will not be there as it's a dictionary, but we have a key value in order to call the value. So see here, I am calling print of d of a. What will be the output? The output will be apple. The output will be apple. When I do print of d dot get of a, here also the output will be apple. That means the value can be called using their keys in two different ways, either by direct indexing the key value here or the key value in the get function. So let us take next method, keys. So keys and values are two important methods of a dictionary which are used to separate or segregate a dictionary into two parts. All the key values will be placed will be separated using keys, and all the values will be separated using the values. See here, K equals to D dot keys of. What happened? All the keys, that is A, 2 and float, have been came to a K. All the keys came to K. Now if you, when you print K, what you will get? You will get A, 2 and here float. Here you will get float. So what it actually means? All the key values, keys, here A is the key, 2 is the key and float is the key, where this is value. So all the keys will be separated when you call K equals to D dot keys. Those keys will came and come and store in K. So when you see it clearly, you can separate the values, you can separate the values using values. So V equals to D dot values of. When you call like this, all the values apple 2 and 10.2 will be stored in V. When you do print V, then we have the values like apple 2 10.2. Got it? Then keys and values are the two different important methods which are used to segregate the values and keys. Then pop off. So earlier we have seen we can remove a particular value using its index. In dictionary, key is its index. So what we can do, we can use a pop off and the key to remove particular element, to remove particular value. So if I use pop off A, then apple and A both will be removed. Update. In order to add the dictionary elements to the existing dictionary, you can use update function to add the elements to the existing dictionary. Items and pop item. So these items and pop item are the things. Items are used to display the existing dictionary in a dictionary view, where pop item will remove a random value, remove a random key value pair from the dictionary. It will return a dictionary by removing certain random key value pair, and it will return the remaining dictionary to the user onto the display. So what we got, nearly we got 10 methods in which keys and values are the two important things which are used to separate the keys and values, and pop item is the thing which is usually random. In general, it will remove the first key value pair from the dictionary. So get is used to get the values from the using the keys. So for more queries and clarifications, come and join me at Vision Technologies, or reach me over gangboard.com. Thank you.